What is up, everyone? This is your host, Eric Holtzman, and welcome to the Mindful Motion Podcast. Good morning, everybody. So it is almost 9:30 here in LA, and I wanted to jump on today and just talk with you guys a little bit about the value of hiring a coach, but also how do you navigate finding your coach? How do you find an expert in the field that you're looking to get results from? So obviously I'm in fitness, so let's talk about fitness. Now, the fitness industry is saturated with tons of people that help people achieve different kinds of goals, weight loss, health-related issues, neurological conditions. We have exercise, performance enhancements, mobility training, all sorts of different type of niches within the market. And there are tons of people out there claiming to have answers. And many of those people have real answers. And some are just parroting from others without truly understanding the details that surround them. And unfortunately, when it comes to the fitness industry, we can have a lot of sharks out there who are just trying to make a sale and just saying what they need to say to get money without truly understanding what's going to work for the individual that they're selling to. So I do want to make a case for hiring a coach, because truly when it comes to fitness and the body, it is a complicated mess of variables that can get a little bit convoluted in regards to how to construct exercise to create the right adaptations for the individual so that they can get what they want from their training. It seems straightforward first glance. And when we think about, okay, I have a goal to lose weight, the answer is easy, right? We just eat less and move more. But the problem is that that doesn't work for most people. Maybe you want to gain muscle, and so you just have to go in the gym and train really hard and push yourself to your absolute limit every day until you break. Well, obviously that doesn't work, because if you can't keep training and you're injuring yourself, that's an issue. So this is where a coach comes in, because they're supposed to know the details surrounding exercise, physics, anatomy, force, the individual criteria that of the person, their health history, their historical context, their skill level. All these factors are supposed to be caked in to the exercise experience to provide the individual with the best training process that will result in what they're looking for. So there's more than one route towards a result, towards a goal. And if anyone is telling you that this is the way and this is the only way, that is false. And they're lying to you. And if they believe that, that's even worse, because they've bought their own lie. So how do we figure out if a coach that you're considering is the right person? You can call them a trainer if you want, just using the word coach. The expert that you're hiring, right? Are they right? Well, you want to do an interview of the coach as much as they're doing an interview of you when you meet them. So my suggestion would be, make sure you're asking detailed questions to that person. Get to know them on a personal level. Try to understand their values as an individual. See if you can make sense of how they think. Because when you think about the fitness industry and what we're doing with fitness, we're dealing with human body. And the human body is a constantly changing thing. And that means that there is no perfect equation, no one size fits all. And the trainer, the expert, should understand that and understand how to make adjustments and modifications and be willing to be wrong. They'll come up with an idea. Here's what we're going to try. If it's not working, okay, no problem. Let's make some changes. If they are stuck in their ways and stuck with one approach, that's a red flag. That should already kind of make you question whether this person's right for me. Okay, so we don't want a person that's so concrete in the way of thinking and putting you into a square hole when you're a hexagon or something. You don't fit into their program. The next thing is, if you're hiring an expert, they should be an expert. They should understand the body. They should understand the joints that they're putting forces through. They should at least have a decent understanding of how muscles contract and work and what might happen if something isn't applied right to the body, or how to make adjustments to an exercise so that it feels better or it gets what gets you the result that you want. So a great analogy would be, think of a chef and a cook. Okay, so if we have a cook at a local diner and they have a recipe of foods they make, it's already pre-planned, it's simple, all they have to do is memorize it and make it, and they just flip burgers, put cheese on it, all simple ingredients, it doesn't take much thinking. That is very different than a Michelin chef who understands how all the different recipes and ingredients interact with each other, how all the ingredients interact. And so they actually know if they put this ingredient with that ingredient to get this result. And they have basically unlimited options here because they know how the pieces work together. So they can come up with nuanced, unique recipes out of their own mind based on their expertise of the pieces of the ingredients, so that they can come up with something truly unique and expert level recipe for someone who might enjoy it. Well, the same thing should be true with fitness. You can have those trainers out there who have worked out, got results themselves personally, followed a certain criteria, a certain plan, and they figured out how to make their bodies lean and strong. So they apply those same principles to everyone else. That's like a cook at a diner. They don't really understand the pieces and the intricacies of all the pieces and how they interact and how to make adjustments. They just do what they did. And that's okay. That might work for 30% of people, let's say. And that's great. I mean, if it works for someone, awesome. What happens if someone spends $3,000 on an online program and that chef's recipe, that trainer's way of doing things doesn't work? Well, now they're out $3,000 and that's disservice to them. Instead, if you had someone who was a chef being an expert in the fitness world, they would understand how all the pieces work and they would be able to come up with a unique way of doing things made for you. And that's what we want. We want someone who really knows the body, who really understands how to look at an individual and make the workout experience and the exercises, build them around that person for their needs. So when you're hiring someone, you want to firstly, there should be a call. There should be a meeting, a consultation of some kind, ideally free of charge, but not necessary. Sometimes people are busy and they need to charge. You got to appreciate the value of someone's time, right? But at the end of the day, there should be an onboarding process, a vetting process for you to vet them and them to vet you. If that's not happening, that's already a red flag. When you're going through the vetting process, ask them questions. Figure out how they take on clients. If they just jump into training right away and there's no form of health questionnaire, there's no form of exercise history, injury history, there's no degree of talking through things about what you've gone through, what you're looking for, that's a red flag as well. So they need to know what you want specifically. They should be asking good detailed questions. They should be attentive. They should be listening. They should care, be compassionate. If they're distracted, if they're on the phone, they're not paying attention to you, that's a problem. That's not a person that you want to hire. So you want to get a sense of who they are, how they do things, figure out if they really do understand what they're talking about by, you know, just diving into some of the details around it. And if you don't know a lot of this stuff, that's fine. You don't have to. You can kind of get a sense if someone understands what they're talking about based on how they answer questions. Are they using one-liner canned sound bites? Or are they being a little more of an expert and not giving you absolutes, but giving you sort of here's sort of how it works. Here are some of the options that could come from this. You know, when it comes to the human body, like I said, there's no one size fits all and it's very complicated. So if someone gives you a direct answer like, oh yeah, if you want to build your chest, it's 4 sets of 10. And then you just progress this way. It's like, no, hold on. that's a general way of looking at it, but that doesn't necessarily mean that's going to work for them. And that's the kind of language and way of thinking that you would want to hear from an expert. Experts never give direct one-liner answers. There's always disclaimers. There's always surrounding context with their answer because that's what's required for true objective understanding of something, at least within science. So I hope this helps you at least initially think about when you're hiring someone, You want to look for someone who's a chef. You want to look for someone who's an expert, who understands the body, who's paying attention, who's empathetic and compassionate, but who also doesn't sound like they have all the answers, because if they do, they probably don't have many. They really should be thinking things through. And that's who you want. You want a thinker. You want someone who's able to take in information, play with that information, reorganize it, come up with some ideas, put together a plan of action. And then if that plan of action is not working, make adjustments, come up with something different, and work on that action, new action plan, with informed decisions based on their understanding of the pieces of the body, of forces and exercise. So there is tremendous value of hiring a coach, without question, especially if you're struggling with whatever it is that you're trying to achieve. Finding an expert can be the route to success. And no question, it won't be cheap, but isn't the value of achieving what you're looking for worth it? All, you know, money isn't going with you to the grave, and you want to enjoy high quality of life. So it's definitely worth doing, but don't get pigeonholed working with someone who really just wants to get your money, doesn't care about you, and also doesn't really understand how to design the exercise experience for your body. All right, guys, this is it for today, but I hope you enjoyed it. Hope it was helpful. And then I'll be talking to you guys soon. Take care.